Hello guys, this is Emil speaking, and in this video I wanted to make a little test bench regarding the use and safety of laser beam bars. I have here set up a red laser beam bar sold in China for $400 to $500 and advertised as being 8x250 milliwatts, and on the other side an ECS 6.4 RGB laser with a Pangolin FP4 card inside. I want you to keep in mind that any laser over 5 milliwatts, so being class 3B or 4, can arm your eyes permanently. So I'm first gonna measure the full power of those two laser systems. On the beam bar, I will just measure one of the beam, and on the 6.4 watt RGB, I will just measure the full red power. So here we can see on the red side, on the beam bar side, we're gonna find around 172 milliwatts. Which is decent. It's not the full power advertised, but close enough. But it's already also quite a big amount of power. This could totally lead to serious eye damage or even skin damage on any person. On the red side, on the ECS side, we're gonna find around 1.4 watts 1.5 watts. I'm running Pangolin to do the test, and the duty cycle on the target mode is not 100%, so we should find a little less than the 1.6. it should be, I would say, 1.3 or 1.4. we're gonna see that in a few seconds, but this is serious amount. This is class 4. You should not shine this at anything that could catch fire, obviously, that no one that could have their eyes on the way, no hands, nothing. I'm gonna just show you with a balloon. It's straight away a blow. You melt the fabric from the outside, and this is the case also on the red beam bar. I have tried before, and it needs about 100 milliwatts to blow a balloon. I'm doing the test again at around the same distance, so obviously the beam bar still blows it. But now on the red side, I have made a pattern, which is just 10 side-by-side dots with the 1.6 at full power. And you can see that the power is somehow lower already, so it doesn't even blow the balloon anymore. And now I'm doing a small test with the power meter. So it's a small hand power meter from Coherent, good for up to a 1 watt. And I still get around 200 milliwatts on the red beam bar. It's a little less accurate than the one on the laptop, but it gives you a rough idea. And on the ECS side now, with the pattern and the scanning and the blanking and everything, once I have a good measure, I get around 20 milliwatts. So way lower what we had before. I'm now going a little further. I'm now about 2.5 meters of the laser beam bar, and now you can still see that the balloon poops even after 2.5 meters of distance. And I'm now doing the test at 10 meters, which is as wide as I can go in that room. Obviously, the big laser system still won't blow the balloon, and the beam bar is not going to be able to do it anymore, simply because the beam size is increasing with the distance. And so the power density is not enough to blow the balloon at this point, knowing it's a blue balloon and could have used dark if I wanted a little more power. We still see the same measurement. I want 20 milliwatts on the ECS, and we still get around 110 to 140 milliwatts on the beam bar, which is still a lot too much to scan audience. And that's the whole point of what I want to show in this video. Those beam bar are dangerous. They are way too much power for scanning the audience. You cannot shine these at people. You are not respecting. I'm not even talking about legislation. I'm just barely talking about safety and safety hazard for the eyes of people. This is over class 3B. We are over 5 milliwatts. We are way over that. We are about 20 times this, even at 10 meters. I would not say maybe around a kilometer away, you would get a power, you know, the beam would get so wide that the power density would be so low that this would not be a problem anymore. But at this distance, this is not safe. And no one reasonable would even use a 6 watt in the audience. This is still over the maximum, the maximum allowed in most country. And you would not shine, you would not have even the idea to hang that low a 6 watt. This is over audience scanning. This is a system you can even use outdoor with decent results. The only way to have a little more security with those beam bars is to make the beam fat. So I have here on propose misalign one of the beam, so it's way wider. So of course I'm still gonna get my 150 milliwatts to 200 milliwatts on the small beams, but on the big one, well, it's so big the beam doesn't even fit at all in the sensor, which is made to be 1 centimeter square. So I'm getting around 20 milliwatts then, which is the same as the other side. It's not perfect, but we're getting into a more reasonable power there. We're still not respecting the class 3 limits, and we're still in class 3B, but this is already better than, you know, shining the straight collimated beam into people's eyes, even if I would not recommend that. And my whole point is really just to say, I have seen too many of these beam bars shining straight into people's eyes. There is a lot of people, I'm using photos here of people knowing how to do it, and you can see they all go to the sky, nothing goes to the audience. And even on demonstration, you will never see these bar going into the eyes of people. Even if it's mannequin here, you can still see they wear safety glasses because they might be hit on stage by the beam bars, but the audience, people facing on front, no one gets any laser beam bars or laser emitted into that direction, because this would just be really dangerous for people's safety. And that's what concerns me. It's why I want to warn people to not do that. This is a nice tool. I'm not talking about if it's something needs or not to buy. This is up to you. But please, if you use it, use it correctly, not into the face of people, not in a zone people can touch. And warn people that if you run a rental company, warn them to take care of what they do. Even if it's fun and easy, this should not be used dangerously. Thank you.